Hi, as you know, few if any authors did as much to define the science fiction as a genre as Isaac Asimov. Nevertheless, there are things, of course, that he got wrong, and today we're going to talk about one of those things, called the fallacy of dumb AI. Before that though, I need to reveal the winners of our last Guess the Book video. If you want to try to guess the book yourself first, click on the link. But now I'm going to reveal the answer. So the book, as many of you have guessed, was Rendezvous with Rama. And the first one to guess it was Another Bibliophile Reads. Congratulations, as I promised, you are now super famous by being featured in this video. And the runner-up who really wanted to get into this video is Surfer Rosamelia. Congratulations and keep it up! Now let's get back to the topic of our today's video. So what is the fallacy of dumb AI? The basic premise is that you can have a super intelligent AI that is at the same time somehow extremely dumb. A good example given by Professor Mitchell is an AI that is somehow involved in governmental decisions. It's super smart, and you tell it, you know, like, we have this pandemic going on, could you please come up with some idea on how to deal with it? And what it does is it says, well, let's just kill all humans, because then there's no pandemic issue. You know, nobody is sick if everybody's dead. So in this case, the machine fails to understand basic underlying assumptions that most human beings share, being that getting sick is still better than just flat out dying right away. And although it's true that we do have machines that are extremely smart in some ways and extremely dumb in others, for example, even a calculator that can calculate faster than any human, but is very dumb in all other ways, it doesn't mean that all the machines that are super intelligent are going to be automatically very dumb on some social level, basically just socially inept, unable to understand the basic human values. And I think that this is something that Isaac Asimov was quite a bit guilty of. He often has those robots that are extremely intelligent, they're even socially competent in many ways, but somehow again and again they fail to grasp the human nature. They fail to grasp something super complicated and deep about how humans behave, as if this is the most difficult thing in the universe. And I think that this tradition of painting AI in a somewhat socially inept way stems from two factors. On the one hand, at the time of writing, and consider The Caves of Steel, the first book in the robot series, was written in 1953. At the time, the AIs were extremely dumb and fully rule-driven. There was very little in terms of adaptability, this kind of fluid AI that can learn on its own that we have today. So it is very understandable that Asimov just could not conceive of an AI that is fundamentally different, very fluid, very flexible, very well-rounded. And the other potential source of this dumb or socially inept AI fallacy is, I think, this pretty strong stereotype that many of us have of this very smart mathematical genius who is socially inept. Rain Man is a perfect example of a movie built around this type of a human character, basically with Asperger's syndrome. This is, however, very misleading. We have this character who is very good when it comes to math and very socially inept, and we think, oh, well, maybe being socially capable is actually harder than understanding mathematics. But if we look at the general population, usually people are pretty okay socially and pretty bad when it comes to math. So usually it's much easier to learn social conventions than to learn higher mathematics. That being said, Isaac Asimov was and remains one of my favorite science fiction authors, and I think his robot series are still very much worth reading. At the end of the day, when we do engineer non-dumb AIs, we might want to have a certain set of principles that we might want to impart into those AIs so that they don't harm us. And what is really cool is that some of the modern AI companies with those large language models, they actually use basically Asimov's laws of robotics as part of their prompts to make sure that the output of the model is actually not harmful and so on. So his legacy lives on. It's very relevant today, and I love his books, even though they are a little bit guilty of the fallacy of dumb AI. And I think one series, for example, which does it a little bit better in this particular aspect is the culture series, where AIs are not dumb, they are different from humans, but they don't suffer from social ineptitude to the same extent. With that being said, thank you so much for being with me today. I hope you enjoyed this little discussion, and let me know your thoughts in the comments, and bye for now.